Good afternoon and welcome to Stock Market Today, sponsored by Interactive Brokers. It's Monday, September 30th. It's the end of the quarter, and we've got a show on the show for you today. Apple Computer, an upgrade there. We also will be looking at Trex, and finally, new Oriental Education, and see how some of the China names are faring. But first, let's go ahead and take a look at the major indexes. I'm Justin Nielsen, along with Ed Carson. And Ed, here we are. It looked like a very strong day, kind of across the board. The NASDAQ composite looks like that was up about 0.75%. The S&P 500 looks like that was up 0.5%. Dow Jones Industrials up 0.4%, and the Russell 2000 up 0.2%. So everything was up, pretty much close to the highs. We're still under the 50-day moving average on the NASDAQ composite, so not everything is all right with the world, right?
Yeah, I mean, the Dow actually is sort of back to where it was a couple of weeks ago. I mean, the Dow never really lost much ground, but the NASDAQ, which has a lot more of the growth names, which has the FANG stocks, you know, that's still struggling. I mean, you get this kind of minor rebound, still below the 50 days. You know, there's not a whole lot of real excitement about it. I mean, it's like it's a partial recovery. There was news over the weekend that was relatively good. On Friday, we sold off on fears of widespread capital controls on China,
right,
including delisting U.S.-listed China stocks. You know, that's not going to happen. The Treasury Department and White House officials came out and said, no, that's okay, not on the table. Mm-hmm. And there's also some relatively upbeat economic data out of China, but it's just a minor move here, really.
And we're going to have a lot of economic data coming out because, again, it's the end of the month, end of the quarter, so there's going to be a lot of things to look at this week. And following that, we've got earnings announcements that will kind of be kicking in as a new earnings season comes in. But let's go ahead and take a look at some of the stocks today. Now, Apple Computer, not Apple Computer anymore, I guess. I still just went back a decade, I guess. But Apple is up significantly today, and this has actually been a pretty good year for Apple overall.
Yeah, I mean, Apple's relative strength is at a 2019 high. Apple's actually the top performer in the Dow. I was a little surprised to see that, but it just sort of been steadily moving along. Microsoft is number two. Those are the only $2 trillion companies, and Apple's back above a 221.47 buy point, you know, acting fairly well. And, you know, again, I said this a few weeks ago, the knock on Apple before is that it wasn't one of the real leaders, mm-hmm, but all those real leaders pretty much got smashed,
right,
in September. So Apple is definitely among those, you know, real leaders now. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't really have great earnings growth, and and even the outlook isn't that great. So it's not entirely clear how powerful of a move you can expect out of a company that basically isn't growing.
Yeah, declining growth the last two quarters.
Declining growth, mm-hmm, they may or may not have declining growth this time. Mm-hmm. You know, next year, it's going to be okay. Nothing spectacular, but still, right now, this is doing very well.
And as you said, you know, you can really see that with the relative strength line. That's the blue line that you see on the chart there, that this really didn't get hit that hard. And so as a result, it really kind of jumped up in terms of the leadership, and that relative strength line is at a new high.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and move on to Trex. Now, a lot of the builders have been kind of showing strength lately. Now, you've got, again, you know, a lot of people talking about the low interest rate environment helping the home builders and you know, construction in general. Trex also has some declining growth in the last couple quarters, though.
Yeah, they had, and that's actually, you know, if you can look back, you see there's a huge gap up there. That's on July 30th. They had declining earnings, but the management said, hey, we had a bunch of production woes, some startup issues. Those are all in the past. We're going to have a much stronger growth. And so, yeah, earnings growth is supposed to pick up in this current quarter, be pretty strong next year, you know, and so that really triggered a real strong sale. And you can't see it here, but it's actually just moving above a buy point from a long consolidation going, mm-hmm, back to last September. It was a pretty deep base, but the base bottomed in October 2018. It's had a long, long run. That earnings gap up was sort of, that would have been buyable. It sort of cleared a consolidation within a consolidation.
Right.
And, you know, so that's sometimes you have to look at the estimates, you know, and if the earnings estimates, if there's a turnaround story, and Trex seems to be a turnaround story, mm-hmm, the sector is pretty strong, as you say.
Yeah.
So that, you know, those are positives going forward.
Right. XHB, which is the home builder ETF, spiders, that looked like it was up about 1.25% today. So, and we keep on seeing those names pop up on our screens in that industry, the building and construction.
You know, they aren't very sexy. You know, it's like, right, it's like, but, you know, that's one reason why you run those screens and you're looking, mm-hmm, I want to find top performing stocks with good earnings and good technicals, mm-hmm, because they may miss those.
Yeah.
because you're looking for the cool names. But, right. Home builders are, and building stocks are working.
And sometimes when all the cool kids are getting, punched in the face, you need to, say, hey, who else is out there? Yeah. Speaking of getting punched in the face, new Oriental Education really got knocked on Friday. And today it really kind of came back. It was one of the strongest, up 4.3% today. But that didn't even recover all of Friday's loss.
Yeah, I lost 6.6%. This was actually one of the better rebounds among the China names. Some of them only recaptured a tiny fraction of their losses. Again, because the whole delisting fears, well, that would obviously...
That would change things.
It's a little bit... So it's sort of like my kids can get a retest and you can get a partial recovery of your grade. Uh-huh. And that's sort of what EDU and a lot of these stocks did. It's still in an ascending base, and it reclaimed the 50-day line. Yeah. So there are some positives. It was sort of a one-day hiccup, you could argue. It's like, there's this delisting fear. Now it's not there, but still... it hasn't gotten back up there. So this is positive, but a lot of the names are out there. China trade talks are going to resume at the end of next week. That's something that's going to be out there for investors, especially in China names like this.
Right. And so this is where sometimes maybe stepping back to a weekly chart, can kind of make that day not look as bad, but that'll all depend on how we close this week. So there's still a lot of days left to go in that regard.
Yeah.
Okay. That'll do it for us today. Don't forget we have another investing strategies that will be dropping today. Ali is in New York at the NASDAQ, and you can find that at investors.com/investing strategies. And also don't forget to follow us on social media. We are on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter, so you can engage with us on any of those social media platforms. That'll do it for us today, and we will see you again here tomorrow. Thanks for watching.